Hey, I'm Nivya and today I'm going to speak about the different book genres available, the most popular ones. When I detail each one of them, I'll ensure to give you a few suggestions as well. Alright, so let's start. So firstly, what is book genre? Book genres are the types and categories of books and it can be mainly divided into three sections: fictional, non-fictional and poetry. Fictions are based on non-factual events, so basically they are from the imaginations of author, while non-fictions are based on real events and facts, while poetry conveys a thought or describes a scene or a story in a lyrical arrangement of words. I personally do not read a lot of poems, but my favorites out of all the ones I have read are Ode to the West Wind, The Road Not Taken, and The Rime of the Ancient Mariner. Now let's go to the subgenres of fiction. Let's start with fantasy. Fantasy uses magic or supernatural form as a primary element of plot. The most popular fantasy book is Harry Potter and the entire series. You can also check out Wizard of Oz and Ninth House. They are also wonderful fantasy books. Next one is mystery. In mysteries, the plot revolves around a crime and the protagonist, that is a hero, solves it. The best way probably for you to understand what a mystery is, The Adventures of Sherlock Holmes. Similarly, you can also go ahead and try Girl with the Dragon Tattoo and The Moving Finger. They are also good mystery books. Thriller. My favorite. It keeps the readers in a state of suspense until the story's resolution. The basic difference between a mystery and a thriller is that in a mystery, the crime is already done and then the protagonist is resolving it, while in a thriller, it's an attempt to stop that crime or further crimes. There are psychological thrillers as well, which emphasizes on the unstable or delusional mental and emotional conditions of characters. You cannot miss Gone Girl, The Girl on the Train, and Before I Go to Sleep if you love psychological thrillers. Romance or romantic fiction. A central love story where the primary focus is on the romantic relationship between two people. Some of the great romantic fictions are Gone with the Wind, Fault in Our Stars, and A Little Something Different. Sci-fi or science fictions. These include themes on technologies or future science, like for example, space explorations or time traveling or even consequences of technological advancements. You should definitely read Journey to the Center of the Earth, 1984, and Time Traveler's Wife if you like sci-fis. Historical fiction. Stories set in the past, often during significant period time, in the backdrop of real historical events. I would definitely recommend you to read Pachinko, Book Thief, and The Help. I love these three books. Horror. The basic motto behind a horror genre is to scare the people, to cause fear to the readers. The best example is Dracula. You can also read Naomi's Room and Stephen King's It. Graphic novels. The stories are conveyed using sequential narrative art, either in a specific design or otherwise in the traditional comic format. My top picks for you guys in this genre are Percy Polis, Hyperbola and a Half, and Blankets. YA or young adult. These books are written or marketed to young adults. That's the age group 12 to 18. You can definitely go for Looking for Alaska, To All the Boys I've Loved Before, and One of Us is Lying. Classics. The works considered to be a representation of the period in which it was written. The best ones to quote are Pride and Prejudice, To Kill a Mockingbird, and Jane Eyre. Children's books. These are basically intended for children, that is below the age of 12. I would definitely suggest each one of you, even if you're not a child, to read the books Matilda, Charlotte's Web, and also Hathi. Now let's go to non-fiction, and to start with, biography. Biographies are details or events of a person's lifespan written by a second person. So basically, the author is writing about some other person and not about himself or herself. You should definitely read Diana by Andrew Morton, Elon Musk by Ashley Vance, and Einstein by Walter Isaacson. Autobiography, an account of a person's life written by himself or herself. You cannot miss these three amazing books, Wings of Fire, I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings, and An Autobiography by Agatha Christie. Memoir, collection of personal memories related to specific moments or experiences in the author's life. The major difference between an autobiography and a memoir is that in a memoir, it's more about establishing an emotional connection rather than just presenting facts. Similarly, in a memoir, the topics are more focused, like to a specific time or to a specific theme of the author's life. Some of the very popular books in memoirs are Becoming and Promised Land. You should definitely try reading Paul Kalanithi's memoir, When Breath Becomes Air. Self-help. These are basically self-improvement books, be it intellectually, emotionally, or even economically. Ikigai, How to Win Friends and Influence People, Who Will Cry When You Die, are must reads in this genre. There are also books related to specific topics like, for example, religion, philosophy, or science. I'm not going deeper into them. All the books which I mentioned today, I'll be sharing their links in the description box. Go ahead and read the books under your favorite genre. Until we meet next time, this is Nivya signing off. Take care. Keep reading a lot of books. Bye.